external dimmer, we need to know this function is only available if we have Hager external dimmer product. Okay, if you don't have this product, you cannot control dimmer objects with Ethernet input output module. Okay, in here we have control mode again with one button or two button. If you select one button, you can control with one object, one output to your outputs, your dimmer. Okay, it will open outputs to for settings dim value by Hager products. Also, this Hager products you can see in here EEA001A. Okay, the connection is here. You can connect with this. Okay, you are just connecting I1 outputs to IO module outputs. Okay. In here, we said we have two button or two but one button or two button for control. Okay. If you select one button, the output will open one, for your percentage, and your dimmer will give dim value to your lights. Okay. Also, you can define two value for up dimmer and down dimmer value. Okay. Also, we have again an enabling condition. If you define some rule in here, you can set if this rule is true, is active, your dimmer will work. If it is not active, if they are deactivated, your external dimmer will not work. Also, you can define two options for your enabling condition. Then these two, both of them is active, you can use your dimmer. Both of them, any one of them is not active, you cannot use your dimmer. Okay. Let's see how we are controlling from manual panel to our devices. We can see these controls. Okay. Firstly, in output config, in global visualization, we can see what we have. We have toggle, external dimmer, and shutter. Also, we have four toggle. Okay. And 9, we have external dimmer again, but it's not connected to our Hager dimmer device, so it will not work. Okay. Also, let's do a manual. Let's open manual panel and see how is it working. For example, in here, in left side, we have virtual inputs. Okay. It's working like this. You are sending 1 and 0, okay, and output is opened because in rule, for example, in output 1 rule, we define a toggle for function and edge type is rising. So when you press up. For example, also you cannot see in here rising or falling. You can feel this control from directly buttons. Okay. And we have control type for logic rule. This is just control from virtual input. Input 1 is 1. If it is 1, output is opened. If it is 0, output will close. Okay, it will work with toggle. Okay, closed, and second toggle. Sorry, again connect, open, close. Okay, let's another one. Let's see another one. For example, if we have any on, we can change output 5 to on off. Let's see if we have any
lights. Yes.
I will change the function to on off. From virtual input, I will control, and from virtual input 5. One is active, zero is deactive. Okay. Or in here we have upload from products and download to products. In here you can take output configuration from device, and you can download these output configuration to device. Okay. First I will do upload. It's processing, getting all configuration for outputs. Okay. Also, if you see, our 9 is changed to not use it. Okay. Let's see what we are using for virtual input 8. Yes. Okay. Now, we will change. It has more rule in here. Maybe we can change other one. For example, first one. Yeah, we can change this one. I will change the on off for input from control or virtual input 1. Okay, and download the product. I'm entering manual panel. If virtual input is 1, the output is opened. Okay. If virtual input 1 is 0, output is closed. Okay, it's working like this. Okay, we finished Ethernet input output video. We see how we are programming our outputs for on-off, for timer, for toggle, shutter, and external dimmer objects. You can define your outputs with these functionalities. Okay, thank you very much.